Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to talk about 0-1 knapsack problem. So I have an old video on this question, but I felt that I missed few things in that video, so I'm creating a new video to fill those gaps. So what is 0-1 knapsack problem? Suppose I have a total weight and then I have certain items with their weights and values. How do you pick items from this set such that the sum of their values is maximum, but sum of their weights is less than or equal to total weight? Also, we have just one quantity of each item. So what does 0-1 mean? 0-1 means that either you pick the item or you don't pick the item. It means that you cannot split the item. So if it was not a 0-1 knapsack problem, just say that you could have split the item. There's a greedy solution to solve that question. All you have to do is sort the item by their value to weight. Sort the item by value to weight in a non-increasing order and then keep picking the items, and then if the last item cannot be picked totally, split it up and pick whatever ratio you can. So but here we are doing 0-1 knapsack problem. It means that we cannot split the item. So how do we do it? Yes, we will use dynamic programming to solve this question. In the next section, let's see how. So how do we solve this problem? So the question is very simple. Whenever a new item comes in, you have to decide you have to pick this item or not, and you have to find which gives you the maximum value. If you pick the item, the maximum value will be the value of the item plus whatever we can get by subtracting this value from the total weight and excluding this item, or the best you can do without including this item altogether. Let's try to understand with this example. So here I have a two-dimensional matrix. And this is my total number of columns is same as the total weight plus 1. And my number of rows is same as the total items. So our first column is 0. It means that if the total weight is 0, no matter what items I have, my maximum value I can get is always 0. So this is why this all is 0. So let's start from here. So if my total weight was 1, and if I just had one item 1, the best I can do is 1. So this is the weight of the item. The total weight is 1. So the maximum value I can get is just 1. If my total weight is 2, if I just had one item of weight 1 and whose value is 1, the best I can do is 1. Remember, we just have one quantity of each item. So even though the total weight is 2, if I just have item 1, best I can do is value 1. Similarly, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So if the total weight is 7, if the only item I have is weight 1 and whose value is 1, the best I can do is 1 because we have one quantity of each item. So next, let's introduce 3. So if the total weight is 1 and if the weight of the item is 3, which is greater than the 1, so 3 can never be selected. So what we do is, what is the best we can do without selecting 3? So basically this number, so that's 1. Again, 2. Since 2 is less than 3, 3 can never be selected since the total weight is less than 3. So the best we can do is, without 3, what is the best we can do, which is this number, so that's 1. Now 3. So since 3 is less than or equal to 3, we have two choices. Do we select 3 or do we not select 3? If we select this item, so we have to check what is the best you can do by selecting this item. If we did select this item, this gives me a value 4. Plus, whatever weight is remaining after we select this weight, so 3 minus 3, so that's 0. So T of 0, and then we go to the top column, so that also 0. So we reach this point. So we go up, we go 3 steps, we reach this point, 3 steps because the weight of this item is 3. So T of 0, 0 is 0. Or what is the best value we can do without selecting this item altogether, and that's 1. So this value is 4 and this value is 1. So max of this is 4. Alright, so the total weight is 4 and the item weight is 3. So again, the best I can do is, without selecting 3, the best I'm getting is 1. If I do select 3, the best I can get is max of, by selecting 3, I get a value of 4, plus I subtract 3 from the 4, so that's 1, And then I go one row up, which is 0 and 1. So this value 0 and 1 is 1. So 4 plus 1, 5. So max of 4 plus 1, 5, or this value 1. So that's 5. Again, where did this 1 come from? Since we selected this item, so this item gives us a value of 4. So whatever, what is the weight we are left with? The weight we are left with is 1, because this guy is going to take 3 weight, and our total weight is 4, so we are left with the weight of 1. And then we check what is the best we can do if we had just weight 1 and we did not include item 3. So that's this guy here, which is why we came to this point. And the best we can do if we had a weight 1, total weight 1, and just item 1 is 1. So that's how we get 4 plus 1, 5. And the best we can do without including 3 is 1. So we get the max of that, so that's 5. Alright, so 5 here. So again, we are checking max of either 1 or weight of value of this guy. So that is 4 plus, we go up and 3 steps back. 1, 2, 3, and reach this point. So this guy, so that is 5. So this value will be 5. So it'll be 5 all the way till the end. So if I had a weight, total weight 7, and if I had 2 items, 1 and 3, the best I can do is, maximum value I can get is 5, which is pretty much selecting both the items. Let's include 4. So since 4 is greater than 1, this item cannot be picked if the total weight is 1. So we'll just get the value without including 4. Without including 4, the best we can do is 1. Similarly, 1, 4. So here, at this point, if we pick 4, we'll get the max of, if we pick 4, then the best we can do is 5, plus we go up and 4 steps back, so that's 0. Or the best we can do without picking 4, which is 5. So in both the cases, we get a value of 5. So let's go here. So here, the best I can do is, if I pick 4, if I pick item this item, the value this item will give me is 5, plus subtracting 4 from 5, so we are left with 1 weight, and we are left with 2 items. So if we have 1 weight and 2 items, that's this value is that value, so that's 1. And then if we did not include 4 altogether, the best I can do is 5. So here the max is 6. So again, to get the 6, we get the value, we pick this item, so the value of this item is 5. Then we go up and we go 4 steps back. 4 steps back because 4 is the weight of this item. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And we reach this point, so we add that value to this value, so that value is 6. So if we include 4, the best we can do is 6, and if we don't include 4, the best we can do is 5. So we take 6 here. So again, for 6, the best we can do is by including this item will be 5 plus going 4 steps back, so that's 1, 6, or this guy, so that's 6. So finally, let's look up for 7. So here, if I pick this item with weight 4, the value I'm getting is max of 4, 5, plus going 4 steps back, 1, 2, 3, 4, so that's 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, so that's 4. Or not picking 4 altogether, and the best I can do with that is 5. So clearly 9 is bigger than 5, so this becomes 9. All right. So if we had total weight 7, and if we had 3 items, 1, 3, 4, the best I can do is 9. So finally, let's bring this last row into the picture. So since 5 is greater than 1, we cannot include 5 into the action, so we'll just get the value from the top. So best we can do without including 5, so that's 1. So 1, 4, 5. So here, so the best, if I include 5, if I include this 5, the best I can do is max of whatever is the value of 5, so that's 7, plus whatever is left after removing this 5 from the total weight, so we are left with 0, so that, and then with the three and with the other three items, so we are left with zero weight, and we are left with three items, so that's this guy, so zero. Or whatever the best we could have done without picking five altogether, so that's six. So here the max is seven. So then we come to this point. So again, what is the best we can do if our total weight is six? If we pick this item with weight five, I get the value of seven, plus we go five steps back, one, two, three, four, five, so one. Or if we don't pick this item altogether, the best I got is six. So eight. Eight is better than six. Finally, let's come to this point. So if I pick this item with weight five, the value I'm getting is seven, plus I subtract five from seven, so I'm left with two, and I'm left with three items. So basically we're going five steps back here, one, two, three, four, five, so one. So 7 plus 1, 8, or the best we can do without including 5, so that's 9. So here 9 is the winner, so this value is 9. So this is the value we can, maximum value we can get by picking items from this set such that the total weight is less than or equal to 7. So if someone asked you what are the actual items which we are going to pick, so let's see how we are going to do that. So we'll start from this point here, our answer, and we'll move and we'll retrace back in this matrix and try to find out the actual items. So this 9, we are checking, where is this 9 coming from? This 9 is clearly coming from the top. It's not coming from this item, it's coming from the top. It means that since this value is coming from the top, it means that this item is not selected. If this item was selected, this value would not be coming from the top. So we know that item with weight 5 is not in the answer. Then we check, where is this 9 coming from? So this 9 is clearly not coming from the 5. So this item must be in the answer. So item 4 with value 5 must be the answer. Then, so this item is selected, then we say, where do we go from here? So then we go up and we go four steps back, one, two, three, four, so this point. So from here, we directly go to this point. Since this item is selected, it means that it must be taking four weight. So whatever weight we are left with, which is three, and whatever two items we are left with, that is where we are going to end up next. So that's this point. So item with weight four and value five is selected. Then we check, where is this guy coming from? This guy is not coming from the top. So this guy, this particular row also must be selected. So the item with weight 3 and value 4 is also selected. So again, now that this item is selected and the weight of this item is 3, so we go up and go 3 steps back and reach this point. As soon as we reach a point where the weight is 0, we are done. So basically, these two items are our selected item, and the total value here is 9, and total weight is 7. So total weight is less than equal to, the sum of the weight is less than equal to total weight, and the value is maximum. Next, let's look at the formula for this problem. So here, I is my column and J is my, I is my row and J is my column. So if J, which is my weight, is less than weight of I, so weight of item I, it means that I cannot be contributing towards J, so our T of I, J will be whatever the best we can do without I, which is I minus 1 and J. Else, it means that weight of I is less than equal to J, then T of ij will be max of either, if item I is included, then value of I plus T of I minus 1 and j minus weight of I. So if item I is included, then value of I plus excluding this item and subtracting this the weight of this item from the total weight, whatever we are left with, so that's t of I minus 1, j minus weight I. So maximum of this, or without including this item altogether, the best we can do, which is t of I minus 1, j. So pretty straightforward here if you understand the how the two-dimensional matrix is built. So this is all I have to talk about 01 knapsack problem. I ask my viewer to like this video, share this video, comment on this video, check out my Facebook page, and check out my GitHub link, github.com/missionpieceinterview wiki. Thanks again for watching this video.